arms. By mixing, we are make a homogeneous mixture of bacterial culture or bacterial suspension, that is mixed culture. We are trying to isolate a single species or single strain. So we are mixing or making a homogeneous mixture by rotating the molten nutrient agar medium between the palms, and then we pour the molten medium into a sterile petri dish. It's already a sterile petri dish, empty petri dish, and we pour the molten medium, and then we are allowed to solidify into inverted position. After solidify, we are incubating them in inverted position, and individual bacterial colony will grown after 24 hours. So this is called a tube dilution technique, pour plate method, tube dilution technique. We are transferring the bacteria, serially diluted them, and to get a lesser number of colonies. Because in soil sample, or you are taking some water sample or air sample, any sample, there are thousands of bacteria is present in the medium. So we are trying to dilute them so that the colonies isolated can be countable within the range of 30 to 300, which can be countable range. So we are making a serial dilution and then transfer 1 ml of culture suspension into the molten agar medium, and then rotating between the palms, mixing them, and then transfer pour into the empty sterile petri dish, which is incubated at 37 degrees Celsius for 24 hours. And next day we are trying to count the number of colonies present on the subsurface medium or which is embedded into the mediums. So the biggest advantage of this method is surface and subsurface colonies are developed. So isolation of micro aerophilic bacteria is possible. I want to say that those bacteria, when I had discussed about strict plate method, those bacteria which can grow on the surface can be countable, can be detected. But what about those bacteria which cannot, which are in micro aerophilic nature? That means they can grow embedded into the nutrient agar mediums. So during the pore plate techniques, those bacteria which are embedded into the medium can also be grown and into a colony. So subsurface and surface colonies are developed and can be counted. So counting of colonies are possible. And the disadvantages of the pore plate technique, that it is difficult to count subsurface colonies. These colonies are grown embedded into the nutrient agar medium, but it is very much difficult to count them, how many they are in number. Time consuming and require a very much skill, microbiology. It needed a microbiological skill during pouring the plate and mixing them between the palms, trying to make a homogeneous mixture. Microorganisms are exposed to higher temperature in liquid medium maintained at temperature 45 degrees Celsius, and that's why it is not suitable for the isolation of psychrophiles, because we are transferring 1 ml of culture suspension into the molten agar medium, which is at 45 degrees Celsius temperature. So those bacteria which can grow at 10 degrees Celsius or 12 degrees Celsius or lower than the 10 degrees Celsius, they are called psychrophiles. They cannot grow inside such medium. The next method is spread plate technique. I will request Neela ma'am to discuss remaining techniques: spread plate, micro manipulator, and serial dilution techniques.
Spread plate technique is also widely used method, and generally it is used for isolation of soil bacteria or the bacteria from natural sources. The microorganisms are spreaded over the solidified agar with sterile glass rod. You are preparing a glass rod which is hockey stick shaped. This hockey stick shaped glass rod is used as a spreader. So microorganisms are sprayed with the help of spreader on the sterile plate, sterile nutrient agar medium or any other agar medium. So here, because of the spreader, even the bunch of organisms are separated, chain of the organisms is also separated. So you can have total separation of the organisms. In this figure, it is shown how exactly the process is carried out. You are taking the spreader. Spreader is put in the alcohol. It is ignited while keeping near the burner. So it will be the sterile rod. Now sterile rod is allowed to cool, and then you have to take some amount of sample. Now in strict plate method, we are using a loopful of suspension. Here we can take from very little quantity of suspension to 0.5 milliliter of suspension. So that much can be added, and with the help of spreader we have to spread the culture. Previous one. Here we are preparing various dilutions of the original sample, and these dilutions, for each dilution we are taking different plates, so that you will get the plates which have isolated colonies. So this way spread plate technique is performed. Now in this technique there are certain advantages and disadvantages. Here count of bacteria is possible, like pore plate method. Pore plate method and spread plate method, both of the techniques permits the bacterial count. As I told you, we can study various types of microorganisms. So we can study microbial diversity of the soil. And as I told you, we can add up till 0.5 milliliter of sample. So volume is higher. So even the rare species, which is present in very little amount, it can also be grow. It can also be detected by this particular method. There is one disadvantage with this technique. That is, first thing is you have to keep totally sterilized condition. We are doing in every method, but here chances of contamination remains, and spreading technique requires little skill. So it has to be done properly, and if more organisms are present and if dilutions are not prepared properly, then you will not get proper isolation, and colony count may be more than 300. So you will not get proper results. Now in all the three methods, strict plate, pore plate and spread plate method, we are getting colonies after incubation. The colonies are distinct. It is the characteristic of the organism, and all the colonical characteristics have been divided into two groups. First, in the first group, the characteristics based on appearance are included, and in the second group, characteristics based on consistency are placed. In appearance, we are measuring size, we are observing shape, margin, elevation, surface. For shape, margin and elevation, I will show the figures also in the next slide. But all right from size to surface, you can get different type of characteristics, and that way you can have identification of the organism. Next. In consistency, we will observe texture, odor, opacity and pigmentation. Texture may be moist, viscous, dry. Odor may be sweet, pungent, and many other orders have been mentioned. In opacity also, transparent, opaque, semi-transparent. In pigmentation, you can get different types of pigments like yellow, red, golden, white, and many other colors may be there. So that is a very good way to identify the organisms. Here, as I told you, the characteristics pertaining to appearance different characteristics pertaining to appearance are shown in the figure. First is shape of the colony that differs, then elevation and age of the colony. So these different shapes are shown in the figure. So this shows that it is a very good character for identification and classification of the organism. Next is serial dilution technique. We don't have to be confused with the dilutions which are prepared during pore plate method and this serial dilution technique. The serial dilution technique which I am going to discuss, that was discovered by Joseph Lister in 1878. Joseph Lister could deliver a single organism in the milk which he named as Bacterium lactis. He prepared various dilutions right from 1 to 10, 1 to 100, 1 to 1000 and many more dilutions, and finally the time came where he delivered a single organism. Now this technique is used here as a serial dilution technique. So here also in the figure it is shown that initially, in initial sample, if 1000 organisms are present approximately, then we will take 1 milliliter of the original sample, we will mix it with the 9 ml of sterile medium. So when you take 1 ml, at that time naturally, now from 1000 the bacteria becomes 100. Now 100 organisms, I mean the medium carrying 100 organisms is again diluted. You will take 1 milliliter from that diluted medium. So that will have now only 10 organisms. 10 organisms that is 1 ml of that diluted sample is inoculated again in 9 milliliter of sterile medium. So we will go on doing this. So finally the stage will come where you have single organism. So from 1000 to 100, 100 to 10, 10 to 1, one organism is present in your medium. Now you give proper growth conditions, grow them, and after 24 hours of incubation, observe the results. You will see that millions of bacteria are present in that sterile medium and they all belong to single type. It's a pure culture. So this way serial dilution technique is performed. So this is just the way to dilute the sample this serial dilution technique. So 1 to 10, 1 to 100 and so on, as I have explained, dilutions are prepared and you have to find out the time where you get a single organism. There are number of advantages and disadvantages also with this technique. You can use this technique, as I initially only told you, to isolate microorganisms from milk, food, soil or any other natural sample. Here, like pore plate method, microorganisms are not exposed to higher temperature. So even all other organisms which requires lower temperature can also survive and can remain in the culture medium. This particular technique is especially very much useful when you cannot grow organisms in solid media. There are certain organisms, it is difficult to grow them. So for them also we are using serial dilution method. There are certain disadvantages also. As such, it is not a very practical method. It's a difficult method and you will get uncertain results. It is tedious method. There are high chances of contamination. And it can be used to isolate numerically predominant member of mixed microbial population. It will allow the growth of only those organisms which are predominant. So the organisms which are not predominant, they cannot be obtained as a pure culture in the last stage. Only predominant species remains in the last dilution of the medium. Now next technique, that is micromanipulator. It was basically discovered by Briefeld to isolate a fungal spore, that is fungal culture, to have pure culture of fungus. It was basically used. Micromanipulator is a device which is attached to the microscope, as it is shown, black colored, that is a micromanipulator. If you look at the figure properly, you can see micropipette. Micropipette is there, and I will show the use of micropipette in the next slide. So it is attached to the microscope, and with the help of micropipette, we are picking up the single spore or single organism, and then it is transferred, then it is expelled to the sterile medium. So this is the process which has been shown, that you have to pick up a single bacterial cell from hanging drop technique, and it is gently sucked. The process is sucking of organism with the help of micropipette, and you have to inoculate it in sterile medium. Either the medium may be present on the in the tube, or it may be present on another cover slip or slide. So then you will allow it to grow, and finally you will get the growth of single kind of organism. Micromanipulator method becomes important because we are observing under microscope, and we are picking up a single cell, so there is no chance of entry of any other organism. But then also